This is Scott Becker with the Becker Private Equity Business Update, and this is a quick discussion of dividend recapitalizations. Fascinating discussion in the Wall Street Journal today about dividend recapitalizations of private equity funds. This year has been an absolute record year for dividend recapitalizations, right about $58 billion, and there's still a few months left in the year. The core of the dividend recap is money is borrowed from a financing source, often the financing source that a sponsored private equity company is already with. That money is then used to make payouts to the owners of the company. So typically the private equity company, the founders, the operators, whoever it might be, depending whatever the ownership that is. This then allows those owners to take some of their money or equity in the company and turn it into equity or cash outside of the company while continuing to own the same amount they own in the company. So they don't give up equity because they're not selling equity, rather doing a dividend recap. So if somebody owns 25% before that, they still own 25%, but now they've taken more money outside the company and put on their personal balance sheet. At least they've made it liquid. In essence, they de-risk their own personal balance sheet by taking money out of the company, but they've added more debt to the company itself, so added risk to the company. It also means that the company will now have increased debt and interest payments to pay going forward. A simple concept is, from a financial standpoint, it shouldn't change the net worth of any owner in a private equity sponsored company, but it changes where their assets and their net worth is at. It means some more, a greater percentage of the net worth is outside the company than in the company. The company's left with a higher level of debt, so a little bit more risk to the company, but less risk to the person's personal balance sheet. In any event, this has been a record year for dividend recaps. Last year, of course, in the pandemic, there was much less of that, so some of that's pent-up demand. This amount of dividend recaps is still a very small amount of the total amount of debt financing that's out there for private equity-sponsored companies. So it's not a crazy number, but it is a fascinating situation in sort of how people look at these things as they help the investors' personal balance sheets, the private equity funds' personal balance sheets, but add more risk to the company itself. And again, to an extent, it's almost a misnomer when I say it helps the person's personal balance sheet. The balance sheet should be the same either way for a person who's an investor in a company, but it means they've taken some of the risk out of the company and put it on their and put that money into their personal balance sheet. So they still have risk in the company, but they've taken some money out, so their own personal balance sheet, at least from a cash position, has been strengthened. I hope this makes sense. In any event, you know, the concept is it helps the investors take money off the table while maintaining their ownership in the company, and a record year for these kinds of dividend recaps. Thank you very much.